Hello, Roadrunners.
It's Friday, March 11th. Welcome back to this week's Roadrunner Report.
Today we have
an interview with Mr. Gouveia,
wrestling footage,
a phone PSA,
and much more on this week's Roadrunner Report. Jog-a-thon, Ella.
I found it fun and I got a better time.
We recorded students in fifth period running the 3 mile.
Let's run over to the track.
Who is the real Stephon Diggs? Is the real Stephon Diggs. Is the real Stephon Diggs.
Wow, those Roadrunners did really good.
Starting Monday, March 14th,
leadership will be doing a scavenger hunt.
Make sure to keep a lookout around campus.
Let's head over to the clip.
Hi, I'm Ellen. I'm here with
Kyrie,
Rachel,
and they're going to tell us about the scavenger hunt planned next week.
Leadership has planned a scavenger hunt for the week of St. Patrick's Day.
It will be from next Monday the 14th through Thursday the 17th.
The winner from each day will receive one of these gift cards from either Best Buy, Target, GameStop, or Amazon.
Good luck, Runner Runners.
Did you know Mr. Gouveia has a secret talent?
What is it?
He's really good at fixing up old arcade games, and he's really awesome at playing them, too.
Our reporter, Gabriel, interviewed him in our studio this week. Let's check out Mr. Gouveia's cool game collection.
Hi, my name is Gabriel, and I'm here with
Mr. Gouveia.
I have a few questions for you. Is that okay?
Go for it.
All right. What made you decide to start building arcade games and machines?
It just kind of happened. I'm a huge nerd. I love electronics. I'm a history guy. And I used to collect video games since I was in high school. I started doing that. And then eventually, never had an arcade. For you youngins out there, we used to actually go to places to play games. We didn't just sit in our rooms and, you know, play on the internet with friends and stuff. We would go to buildings with a handful of quarters and pump them into arcade games, and that was a big social event for us when we were younger. So once I had my own house and a place where I can kind of, you know, do a lot of the things I've always wanted to do when I was little, I eventually found an arcade for really cheap. It was broken down. And I brought it home, and that's what kind of got me interested, and I've been hooked ever since. I just love working on electronics and things, and I love the history behind video games and that sort of stuff.
Awesome. What is the most valuable game you've, like, fixed up or played?
That's kind of hard to answer. I've had a few games that are worth, you know, mm-hmm. because they're kind of rare. I've had like one of my favorite arcade games called Robotron. It's a really hard one to find. Incredibly fun game. A lot of people don't know about it because, again, this is a late 70s, early 80s game, and it was a game. If you put a quarter in, your game was over like in 10 seconds. So, in terms of making money, it wasn't a big deal. It wasn't very big because of that. You know, businesses, they want games that kids are going to constantly put money in, like Donkey Kong and Pac-Man and stuff. So it's kind of a rare game. So therefore, it's a little bit more expensive if you want it. And then I have another game called Zookeeper, which is another one of those rare games that was released in the video game crash of 1983, and so there's not many of them were made, so it's kind of rare.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Are you fixing up any games currently?
Yeah, I actually have a few games that I'm working on in my free time. I have a few different. I have a Centipede game. This right here is an arcade. This is a PCB. This is a game right here. You youngins, you're used to your discs or digital downloads. They don't even have discs anymore for most of this stuff. This right here is what a game would have been placed on a PCB. So like this game right here, it's not working. So I will be taking this home and hooking it up and trying to, you know, get it working again, which that's part of the fun. I think right now in my old age, I have more fun repairing this old stuff than I do playing the games now.
Awesome.
Yeah, so, you know, I always have something going on. It's just part of who I am.
Oh, that's great. And what is your favorite game you have ever fixed up?
Oh, by far, Robotron. It's what you call a twin stick shooter. It's like you got two joysticks and one of them controls a little guy and the other one kind of shoots.
Oh.
It is a really, really fun game, a game I never knew about because even like this one, I wasn't even born yet when this game came out. And Robotron is another one of those. It came out before I was born. I never knew about it until recently. It's a really, really fun game. So those of you guys out there that like, you know, your Fortnites and stuff, Robotron is the predecessor, the granddaddy to Fortnite and all of those games that you guys are playing. It's really, really fun, very hard, but it's really addicting. It's a really good game.
Awesome. Okay. Thank you for your time.
No problem. Thank you.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Mr. Gouveia here. We are going to play some Robotron together. This is my favorite arcade game of all time. Again, it's called Robotron 2084. It's a very early game. Came out in 1982, before I was born. And you know, you guys all know about Pac-Man and Donkey Kong, you know, the well-known classics. This game didn't get much love early on because it was just such a hard game and a very fast-paced game, so people burn through quarters too quickly. So you are this little guy right here, and your job is to try to rescue a family from robots and from aliens. And the more people that you pick up consecutively, the more points that you get. Every 25,000 points, you get an extra life. This is a type of game where there is no ending. The goal is to just try to get the highest score that you possibly can. And that's how most early arcade games were. No ending, just you try to get the highest score. I'm not very good at this game. I'm just going to be honest with you, but I love playing this. If I only have like 5-10 minutes to jump on an arcade to play, this is the game I go to first. It's what we call a twin stick shooter. There's no buttons to press. All you have is two joysticks. One does the walking, moving the character. The other one does the shooting. So let's give this a go, guys. Very fast-paced game. It starts out easy. The robots are trying to get me. I'm trying to get the family members before the robots get them, or I get hit. And those little barriers that if I run into, I lose a life. So, all right, went through the first screen. Again, starts out easy. Gets hard very, very quickly. And there's some strategy to this. For example, I didn't want to take those guys out yet until I collected the family members, try to build up some points. In this game, one of the strategies is you want to keep going in the same direction, because if you go backwards, that doesn't usually end very well. Oh man, I had a chance to make a run right there. Down to my last life, guys. Thank you. Not doing so good today, guys. I keep earning an extra life, so staying in the game up until there. And guys, that is Robotron in my favorite arcade game of all time. Maybe next time I can play something else. All right, guys, I'll see you later.
Hey, Roadrunners. Happy Friday. Hopefully you're doing well. This is Mr. Lai here. I wanted to speak with you because we didn't have a chance to speak after that 3-on-3 basketball tournament that took place a few weeks ago. Now, I just want to say a few things about that. First and foremost, we are the champions, me and Mr. Mew and Mr. Nguyen. We won the tournament. You saw it. Yes, it happened. And I want to give a few thank yous, a few shout outs, right? First of all, both all of us and all the teams that we played and beat played real hard, played very hard, and it was a great tournament. I want to give a big thank you to, again, my teammates, Mr. Mew and Mr. Nguyen. They carried the team. I was just along for the ride, and it was a pleasure to see all the buckets they were getting. It was just wonderful. I also want to thank Mr. Avalar, who stepped in and was designated hitter getting buckets. So thank you to Mr. Avalar. I also want to thank Mr. The Fountain for putting on a wonderful tournament to where we as teachers could get buckets on all these students. I also want to thank Mr. Coxford for capturing all those bucket getting moments on camera, on film, on footage. It was wonderful. Buckets. I also want to thank my mom for supporting my bucket getting. I also want to thank my my pet fish, Lizzie. Always showed me how to keep on swimming and keep getting buckets. Rest in peace, Lizzie. My classmate, my third grade classmate, Miguel, right, who told me, hey, you're not very good at basketball. And that has fueled me to this day. So this one's for you, Miguel. Right, hold on, I got a second page here, hold on. And we can just, you know, we can put it out there because I don't mind. I'm sure you won't mind either, right? So thank you to all the losers who we played. Again, if you want to be a winner, you got to have loot. There's got to be a loser, right? And we can name them off, right? Just to let them know thank you. So thank you to Amari. Thank you to Roger. Thank you to Zach. Lee, you got lucky. Okay. Thank you to Aiden, Jose, Elijah. Thank you to Jaden, to Nathan, to Bo, to Rudra, to Jeet, to Ethan. All the losers that we had to beat in order to get to the top and become champions. Thank you. Yep, we are the champions. And as champions, we deserve and we get some pizza, right? And I actually ate the pizza the other day. But I got some extra celebratory pizza right here. So in celebration of our victory, let's eat some pizza. So you can hear me eating pizza. Did you see my face? Again, I'm not done. I got another page. Hold on. No bed of roses. I have been told, this is just rumor, I have been told that there was a fifth period championship team. Now, I don't know who that fifth period championship team is. I've been told it's some kid with a broken arm. I don't know. Doesn't matter. We're here, Mr. Nguyen, Mr. Mew. I'm sure they're available as well. I'm here to play a game between the fourth period champions and the fifth period champions. If you want to play, we'll get some buckets. I'll be ready. Okay, my foot. We'll be ready. And also one more thing. We as a collective, especially fifth period, you were lucky. You were lucky that Mr. Britt held back and did not play, right? I think in Tennessee they call him Britt the Bucket, okay? So just be aware. Mr. Frenfrock, ooh, you lucky you didn't play. You were lucky you did not play, okay? Otherwise, we might be seeing them in any potential championship game, all right? Britt the Bucket, Frenfrock with his floater. Yeah, good tournament. Mr. Lie out.
And now for today's man on the street question.
What's the most ridiculous thing that someone has told you and you believed?
My dad told me that the Tooth Fairy gives out Girl Scout cookies.
Let's see what the Roadrunners have to say.
Hi, I'm Alan. I'm here with
Brianna.
And today's man on the street question is, what's the most ridiculous thing anyone's ever told you?
That their cat ate their fish and the fish ate the cat.
Hi, I'm Alan. I'm here with
Marco.
And today's man on the street question is, what's the most ridiculous thing anyone's ever told you?
My dad's gonna come back.
Hi, my name's Ellen. I'm here with
Camden.
And today's Man on the Street question is, what's the most ridiculous thing anyone's ever told you?
That's not school appropriate.
Thank you.
Now we have a phone PSA.
Please keep your phones in your backpack
and turned off.
Let's snap to the PSA.
This is what not to do with your phones.
Bro, the stupid Samsung, bro, it's lagging, bro.
Bro, restart your Samsung, bro.
Bro, I did.
Bro, we need to finish this game class.
Oh, I'm trying. Oh my, what is that, bro?
What is that, dude? It looks like tomatoes stacked on top of each other with a
hey, guys.
Oh.
You guys know you're not supposed to
finish. I'm sorry.
I'm gonna see you guys on your phone, okay?
Yeah. Okay.
All
right. Sorry.
Sure, sure.
Bye.
I'll be looking.
Bye, yeah. Mr. Jacob.
This is what to do with your phones.
Hey guys, look at.
Oh my gosh, that is so.
What is that?
Oh my god.
Hey guys, you guys can put your phones away? Yeah, that's what's happening.
Sorry.
I really appreciate you guys. Thank you guys.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Have
a good day.
Yeah, you too.
Well, that's the end of this week's show.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next Friday.
Don't forget, on Monday, it'll be optional to wear a mask.
Have a wonderful weekend.
Bye.
Don't make it obvious. Okay, stop.
I'm gonna look at one time. There.
How's my hair look? Oh, we're rolling? Oh, okay.
It will be from the...